माइक
आवाज क्यों करो।
अच्छा
आणि
पार्टिसिपेंट झालेले जॉईन त्यांनी चॅट बॉक्स येते. चालेल इथं जायचं क्लिअर मध्ये गेलं का क्लिअर क्लिअर ऑन करायचं सगळं काय आठवण.
गुड आफ्टरनून स्टुडंट्स, आवाज येतोय सगळ्यांना क्लिअर?
येस सर, आवाज येतोय.
येस सर,
आवाज येतो तर मेसेज करायचा आहे. ओके येस स्टुडंट्स, लिटिल प्रॉब्लेम वॉज देर. ओके नाव इट्स क्लिअर. स्टुडंट्स डू यू नो यस्टरडे वी हॅव फिनिश most of the questions of normality, and in normality yesterday even equivalent weight we have finished. Today we'll see what is the relationship between this normality and molarity. Okay, just a minute. Okay. So yes students, today we are going to see relation between normality and molarity. Okay students, yes, you know what is the molarity? Yes, yeah. can anybody tell me what is molarity?
Number of moles of solute upon volume of solution.
Yes, what is molarity? Students, molarity is number of moles of solute upon volume of solution in liter. Molarity is number of moles of solute upon volume of solution in liter. And what is normality, students? Number of gram equivalents. Number of gram equivalents upon volume in liter. Okay, now if I take the ratio of this normality upon molarity, if I take a ratio of normality upon this molarity, so students, this volume will get cancelled and you will get number of gram equivalent upon number of moles of solute. Yes, I am audible to everyone.
Yes,
please
sir.
Confirm whether I am audible.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Check whether can you on your mic whenever you want to talk with me.
Yes, sir.
Yes, students, you need to unmute and tell me how to find a number of gram equivalents. How to find a number of gram equivalents? Tell me. How to find a number of gram equivalents?
गिवन मास अपॉन इक्विवेलेंट मास.
यस टेल मी हाउ टू फाइंड द नंबर ऑफ ग्राम इक्विवेलेंस. यू कैन अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ एंड टॉक विद मी. Yes, yesterday three steps, on Saturday three steps I taught you. Then in that one step was how to find the number of gram equivalents.
Mass upon equivalent mass.
Yes.
Given mass upon equivalent mass.
Yes, Bosley. Yes, Bosley Siddesh. Yes, Sumit. Sumit, can you tell me how to find number of gram equivalents?
Given mass upon equivalent mass.
Yes. Yes, number of gram equivalents. Yes, very good. Some of the students have said, students, number of gram equivalents is given mass upon equivalent weight. Very good. Okay, now I am audible to you, Joshi. Tell me whether I am audible or not.
Yes, sir.
Abhishek Joshi. Yes. Students, number of gram equivalent is what? Given mass upon equivalent mass. And students, you know how to find the moles. Moles is given mass upon molecular weight. So students, this given mass will be cancelled. This molecular weight will go up. So you will get the formula N upon M is equal to molecular weight upon equivalent weight. Because students, this given mass will be cancelled. So molecular weight. So I'll write it as MW molecular weight. Students, do you know equivalent weight can be written as molecular weight divided by valency factor X? So this will get cancelled, and finally you'll get N upon M is equal to X. That M, this M, if I send here, I'll finally equation, I'll get N is equal to X into M. So students, this is very important formula. This is a very important formula. Note down this formula. This is a very important formula. N is equal to X into M. What is this X? X is valency factor. Yesterday I taught you how to find this X. X for acid is how much H plus it gives. X for base is how much OH minus it gives. And X for salt is total positive charge on cation. Total positive charge on cation. Please note down this. Okay, now the formula is N is equal to M into X. Means students, if normality is given to you, you can find the molarity, and if molarity is given to you, you can find a normality. If I give one question, find normality of 0.4 molar H3PO4. Students, here molarity is given, you need to find a normality. So can you find it? Find the normality of 0.4 molar H3PO4. You want to find normality. So molarity is given 0.4. Now into this x you need to find. And that day I taught you, whenever S3PO4 is there, whenever S3PO4 is there, first you need to draw the structure. P double bond O. Then how many oxygens are left? 3, 1, 2, 3. Yes, Sumit, very nice. It is 1.2 because here H, here H, here H. How many hydrogens are attached to oxygen? This one, 3. So its valency factor is 3. So the normality will come 1.2. Very nice. Yes, most of you have given the correct answer. Yes, students, next question. Find molarity. Find molarity of 2NH2SO4. Normality is given. You want to find the molarity. So the formula is N is equal to M into X. And this time M you need to find. So what will be M? M into will be N up divided by X. Here it is given 2 normal upon X. What is the valency factor of H2SO4? Yes, very good, Pranjal. It's 1 molarity. Yes, because the valency factor is 2. Yes, students, it's valency. Just a minute. Once more, I'll write. Find molarity of 2 normal H2SO4. So, we know the formula N is equal to M into X. So M will be N upon X. So N is already given. And you know H2SO4 gives 2 hydrogens. So divided by 2. So it is 1 capital M, mostly capital M, because capital M represents molarity and small m represents molality. Yes, very good. It's capital M. Yes, very good. Now, students, we are talking about normality of mixture. Normality of mixture, within 2-3 minutes, we'll finish this normality. Okay, normality of mixture. Now, students, whenever mixture is there, either you see whether it's written acid plus acid, 2 acids are mixed, or base plus base. If 2 bases are mixed, then you'll use formula N1V1 plus N2V2 upon V1 plus V2. And then you'll be able to find normality. But students, when you will use this formula, you will use this formula only when acid-acid is given and base-base is given. When acid and one base is given, what to do? That I will teach you. First, when 2 acids are given, two same acid or 2 same base, you need to use this formula N1V1 upon N2V2 upon V1 plus V2. So one question you solve for this. If I say you 0.2 normal, 200 ml HCl plus or is mixed with 0.3 normal 300 ml, find normality of mixture. Find normality of mixture. So the formula will be, okay, here also HCl is there, here also HCl is there. Okay, both are acids, HCl. So we can use formula N1V1 plus n2 v2 upon v1 plus v2. Yes, calculate it and find, tell me the normality. Two acids, same acids are mixed, then only you'll use this formula. Or two base are used, same base are used, then you'll use this formula. Find the normality. So, yes, Pranav, very good. Yes, Pranav got the clear answer, 0.26. Yes, Sumit also got the clear answer. It is a 0.2 into 200 plus, yes, Pranjal, it is 0. Yes, 0.26. That's correct. 0.3 into 300 divided by total is 500. Yes, so the answer is 0.26. Yes, very good students. The answer is 0.26. That's correct. Okay, no students, here no need of roundup. If what you need to do, you need to just see which options are given. According to that, you need to write your answer. Okay. Now students, the main problem is there. If one acid and one base is given, then what to do? Students, now please make a star point here. This is very important. Very, very important. Very important. What if, sir, one acid is given and one base is given? Students, when acid and base is mixed, you know, neutralization will take place. So in that first step, you need to check. Na, Va. What is Na? Normality of acid. V is the volume of acid. If this product is greater than Nb, Vb. Means N into V of acid is greater than N into V of base, then the resultant solution will be acidic. Resultant solution will be acidic. And second, if NaVa is smaller than NbVb, then the resultant solution will be basic. These two conditions, first you need to check whether the resultant solution is acidic or resultant solution is basic. If the resultant solution is acidic, if a resultant solution is acidic, then you need to use this formula, students. N is equal to, because here NaVa will be greater, so NaVa minus NbVb upon Va plus Vb. And if it is basic, then you need to use formula NbVb minus NaVa upon Va plus Vb. So first, what you need to check, students, whether the NaVa is greater than NbVb, then you need to use this formula. And if NbVb is greater, then you need to use this formula. So now we'll take a question. Students, if 0.2 normal, 100 ml HCl plus 0.3 normal NaOH is given. Find normality of mixture. So first you check NaVa and NBVB. First check which one is greater. From here only you can understand, okay, 0 into 2 into 100. So that will be 20. And here definitely this will be greater. So definitely it is a basic. So for basic norm, what you need to use formula? NBVB minus NAVA upon NA plus NB. So it is 0.3 into 300 minus 0.2 into 100. 200 plus 100, that is 400. Yes, you can find it. Yes, Pranjal says it is 1.75. Yes, now the problem is Pranjal says 1.75, Pranav says 0.175. Just check it. This comes 90. Yes, it comes out to be, yes, 0.175. Yes, that's correct. 0.175. Very good. Okay. Solve one more question, students. If it is given, zero point two normal, 500 ml SCL plus 0.1 normal, 100 ml KOH. Find normality of mixture. First, check the product. Now definitely your acidic product will be more, so resultant solution will be acidic. So you need to use formula NaVa minus NbVb upon Va plus Vb. So definitely it comes out to be 600 ml. Solve this fast. Yes, 0.1, 0.15. Yes, very good, Pranjal. Student, just check whether you can on your mic or what.
Yes, sir.
Yes, if you want to talk with me, can you on your mic?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, very good. So wherever you want to talk with me, you can on your mic and talk. Okay. So now very important point, students. Most of the time, the question is asked on equivalent weight. Most of the time, question is asked on equivalent weight. Today, all deep question will solve about equivalent weight. Students, equivalent weight is a molecular weight divided by factor X. Yes, students, I taught you how to find factor X for acid. Tell me how to find factor X for acid. This is called as valency factor.
Number of H plus ions.
X is called as valency factor. For acid, students, it is, yes, can anybody tell me before I tell?
Number of H plus
for
ions.
For acid, how will you find the value of X? Yes, very good. Number of H plus ions it gives. After dissociation, number of H plus ions it gives. Students, X for base, can you tell? X for base. Yes, very good. The number of OH minus it gives. Very good. Number of OH minus it gives. And X for salt. That is, this I will tell, total positive charge on cation. Very good. Or you can say anion, because cation and anion charge is same, then only it gets cancelled and the overall molecule is neutral. Yes, very good. Now students, we'll go much deeper into its equivalent weight. Students, if you look at equivalent weight definition in the sheet provided to you, so they will say that equivalent weight is a weight which combines with 1 gram hydrogen, 8 gram oxygen, and 35.5 grams chlorine. Equivalent weight is weight which combines with 1 gram hydrogen, 8 gram oxygen, and 35.5 grams chlorine. Students, what it means? Now, if I take an example. Here, if I take an example, CH4. You know carbon's weight is 12 grams. And hydrogen's weight is 1 gram. So total 4 hydrogens are there. So 4 gram. So look at this definition. Equivalent weight. What is equivalent weight? Which combines with 1 gram of hydrogen. Suppose if I'll take 1 gram of hydrogen here, if I'll put X. So what is the value of X? 4, the value of X comes to be 3. So equivalent weight of carbon in this, it is 3. Equivalent weight of carbon here, it is 3. The second example, if I'll take here, H2O. Here, hydrogen's weight is 2 grams. Oxygen, you know, it is a 16 grams. But I told you, equivalent weight is what? When it combines with 1 gram of hydrogen. So when this is 1 gram, this will be divided by 2. So it will come out to be 8 grams. Is the equivalent weight of oxygen 8? Yes, it's correct. So what is the equivalent weight, students? Equivalent is the weight when it combines with 1 gram of hydrogen, 8 gram of oxygen, and 35.5 grams of chlorine. Okay. Now, next question, you need to solve it. Next question, you need to solve it. Find the equivalent weight of sulfur in this case. Find the equivalent weight of sulfur. Directly also you can tell what is the equivalent weight of sulfur. Just tell me fast. Students, sulfur's weight is 32 and chlorine is 35.5 into 2, that is 71 grams. But I told you, equivalent weight is the weight when it combines with 1 gram hydrogen, sorry, only H, 8 grams oxygen, and 35.5 grams chlorine. So here, if I take 35.5, so here I need to take 16 grams. So 16 grams is the correct answer. Okay, this one you try. Yes, Fe2O3. Fe2O3, Fe's weight is 56. 1 Fe's weight is 56. Can you tell me equivalent weight of Fe in this compound? Yes, Sumit, Pranav, tell me fast.
Sir, 16, how came?
I am audible to everyone. Tell me fast. Yes, 18.6. Yes, Pranjal, that's correct answer. 18.6. Students, you see. No, Abhishek Joshi, I cannot hear your voice. That only I'm asking. I'm not able to. Okay, just a minute. Abhishek Joshi, unmute yourself and talk with me. Let me see whether I can hear you.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, let it be in message. You can see here. Fe is 56. It is 2 times means 112 grams. And oxygen is 16. 16 is of 48. 48 gram of oxygen combines with 112. But if you want equivalent weight, you need to check with 8 gram oxygen. So here it will be X. So 112 into 8 divided by 48. So X value comes out to be 18.66 grams. So equivalent weight of Fe is 18.66 grams. Okay, students, equivalent weight of calcium, you find out equivalent weight of calcium. I think so orally also, without solving also, you can tell it very easy. It is equivalent weight of calcium. Equivalent weight is weight when it combines with 1 gram hydrogen. Yes, very good. 20 finished, because calcium is 40. But when it is 40, students, when it combines with 2 gram, equivalent weight means when it combines with 1 gram hydrogen. So equivalent weight is 20. Yes, that's correct. Find it for this one. CO, carbon monoxide. You need to find the equivalent weight of carbon. Pranjal, see properly whether it is 12 or what? Yes, Pranjal, it is 6. It's not 12, students. Now again, you are making a jumbling. Carbon is 12 grams. Yes, I agree with you. Oxygen is 16 gram. Yes, I agree with you. But students, I told you equivalent weight is a weight when it combines with 1 gram hydrogen, 8 gram oxygen, 35.5 gram chlorine. So it is when it is 8 gram, this has to be half. So it will come out to be 6 gram. Yes, that's correct. Yes, one last one you solve. S2Cl2. Find the equivalent weight of sulfur. S2Cl2. Find the equivalent weight of sulfur. S2Cl2. Find the equivalent weight of sulfur. Yes, very good, 32. Now everyone got it. Because students, sulfur is 32, so it is 2 times, so 64. Chlorine is 35.5, but it is 2 times, means 71. But equivalent weight is weight when it combines with 35.5 chlorine. So 71 half is 30.5, so 64 half is 32. So this is the correct answer. Now students, the main thing is there, sir, what kinds of questions are asked? What kinds of questions are asked? Now see here, this is the question which was asked. a metal oxide, write down the question, a metal oxide contains 40% oxygen, 40% oxygen by weight. Then equivalent weight of metal is, the equivalent weight of metal is, students, they said metal oxide contains 40% oxygen by weight, then equivalent weight of metal is. Students, one metal oxide is there. Out of that, oxygen is a 40%. Then metal will be 60%. By weight means this will be 40 grams. This is 60 grams. Now you can easily find the equivalent weight of metal. Now you can easily find the equivalent weight of metal. Pranjal says 48. How come, Pranjal, it is 48? Pranjal, equivalent weight is the weight which combines with 1 gram hydrogen, 8 gram oxygen, and 35.5. Yes, Sumit Pagar is the correct answer. He has given the correct answer. So when I take here 8 gram, just cross multiply it. So it will come 60 into 8 divided by 40. So this zero cancel, this zero cancel. So the answer comes out to be 12. Yes, answer comes out to be 12. Yes. Students, can I solve by using this formulas here? Percentage of oxygen upon percentage of metal, equivalent weight of oxygen upon equivalent weight of metal. Yes, percentage of oxygen was given how much? They said 40%, so I put 40. And then remaining will be metal, so it will be 60. Equivalent weight of oxygen, I know 8. Upon equivalent weight of metal. This also formula I can use. Just cross multiply and see it. So this formula also you can use. Yes, very good. Okay, now see the next one, students. Generally oxygen and metal, many times question is asked. So actually the formula is percentage of atom. Write down the formula. Percentage of atom is equal to equivalent weight of atom upon equivalent weight of atom plus equivalent weight of element joined with atom. Element joined with that atom into 100. Suppose if I talk about percentage of oxygen, so what is equivalent weight of oxygen? 8 upon, what is again here, it is A, means again it is 8 plus equivalent weight of that particular metal into 100. Suppose if I talk about percentage of metal, students, I don't know what is the percentage of metal. So what is equivalent weight? So I'll write equivalent weight of metal plus equivalent weight of metal equivalent weight of metal plus 8 into 100, because here I'm talking about when it is combined with oxygen. When it combines with oxygen. So if I take the percentage of it, if I take a percentage of it, it will come out to be here the final answer will come equivalent weight of oxygen upon equivalent weight of metal is equal to equivalent weight of oxygen, that is 8 ionoid upon equivalent weight of metal. Yes, students, this formula you use. So same formula, can you tell me for hydrogen what will be percentage of hydrogen if it is given? First, equivalent weight of hydrogen is 1 upon 1 plus equivalent weight of that metal into 100. Or equivalent weight of chlorine, how you can write? I know equivalent weight of chlorine is 35.5 upon 30.5 plus equivalent weight of that metal with which it is associated into 100. Okay, students, these formulas you write down. Once one or two questions you will solve, you will be very comfortable with this formula, students. Now I will take the questions which are asked in exam previous, whether it's NEET exam, whether it's IIT exam, whether JEE exam. These questions are asked, so that questions now I will take. Okay, now see here, the question says a metal oxide contains 40% oxygen by weight, then percentage of chlorine in its chloride will be. First, students, this much information you need to check out. The metal oxide contains 40% oxygen. Again, metal oxide is there, 40% oxygen. That means metal will be 60%. Again, same formula, percentage of oxygen upon percentage of metal is equal to equivalent of oxygen upon equivalent of metal. Your percentage is given 40%. Here it is given 60%. Yes, students, it comes out to be 12. Yes. Now, what formula I told you for percentage of chlorine? That is equivalent weight of chlorine is 35.5 upon 30.5 plus equivalent weight of EM, where we are writing now, we got equivalent weight, that is 12. Into 100. So can you tell me what will be the answer? What will be the percentage of chlorine? Students, from where we have taken this formula? Now only I told you, if we are chlorine, if it is equivalent weight of hydrogen, you will take 1 upon 1 plus 12 into 100. Because the question was asked about related to oxygen, and then they changed and they said the percentage of chlorine in its chloride will be. So percent of, here we have found equivalent weight of metal that I have substituted here. You find it and tell me the percentage of chlorine. Tell me percentage of chlorine. Yes, Sumit says it is 75%. Yes, that is the correct answer. Let me see if any other answer is there or not. Yes, students, it is 75%. It is nearly with 75%, correct? Yes, 74.7. So we'll just round up and we'll write it as 75. Or if option it is given 74.7, then also it is correct. But I think so in option that time it was given 75%. Yes, very good. Okay, take down the next question, students. Equivalent weight of a metal. Equivalent weight of a metal is 9 and atomic weight is 27, then formula of metal chloride will be. Very nice and very interesting question, students. Equivalent weight of metal is 9 and its atomic weight is 27. Then the formula of metal chloride will be. Students, what is equivalent weight? How we find equivalent weight? Do you know equivalent weight is a molecular weight divided by valency factor X? So can I write equivalent weight instead of molecular weight? If atomic weight is given, then atomic weight divided by valency factor X. Here equivalent weight is given, students. Here equivalent weight is given 9 upon atomic weight is given 27, and from here we can find valency factor X. So what will be the value of X? X will be 27 by 9. Very nice question, students. Very nice question. Yes, students. This is 3. Students, valency is 3 and they said metal. It is metal. They clearly said it is metal and its valency is 3. So can I say this metal is there, its valency is plus 3 because metals are usually plus. Yes, students.
Yes, sir.
Metal is plus and you know chloride is minus 1. So can you make a formula from it? Because the question was asked same, then the formula of metal chloride will be. We know metal is plus 3, not AlCl3. You don't think which metal is given. Did they mention that metal is aluminium? No, it's not aluminium. Yes, that's correct. So your answer will be MCl3. Yes, that's correct. MCl3. They did not mention that metal is aluminium. Okay, if they mention that metal is aluminium, then only you can write that. Okay, take down the next question. Your question is equivalent weight of bivalent metal is 30. Then molecular weight, then the molecular weight of its chloride will be. Equivalent weight of bivalent metal is 30, then molecular weight of its chloride will be. Students, bivalent metal means M is plus 2 and chloride is minus 1. So what will be the formula? MCl2. The formula will be MCl2, but we want to find the molecular weight of this metal first. Only here equivalent weight is given. Yes, Pranjal, let me check it. Okay, what is the formula? Equivalent weight is equal to molecular weight divided by factor X. Your equivalent weight is given 30. Molecular weight, I don't know. X is valency, so this is 2. So 30 into 2, molecular weight is 60. So let us check. Now MCl2, here molecular weight is 60. Chlorine is 35.5 into 2. So 60 plus 71.
130.
Yes, very good. Once more I'll solve this, students. Once more I'll solve this. Okay, so students, once more I'll solve it. See, here clearly they mentioned that metal is bivalent. Bivalent means its valency is 2. And they said the chloride formula with it. First, we'll see the formula, and they said the molecular weight. So chloride, you know, it's -1. So the formula will be MCl2. And you know, students, equivalent weight is equal to molecular weight divided by factor X. Equivalent weight, they had given 30. They asked us to find the molecular weight first. Actually, they told us to find the molecular weight of complete compound and the valency factor. They clearly in the question, they mentioned this is a bivalent. Bivalent means the valency is 2. So the molecular weight of that particular metal is 60. So we know formula is MCl2. So if this is 60, chlorine we know it's 35.5, but it is 2 times. So 60 plus 71, that is 131. That's clear answer. Yes, understood. Any problem up till this? Okay, students, one more point. Equivalent weight of iron. Equivalent weight of iron is formula weight upon total charge. One more, if they ask you equivalent weight of iron, the formula is formula weight upon total charge. If they ask you NH4 plus 1. Students, this NH4 plus 1 is called as ammonium. So first I'll find the formula weight. Okay, nitrogen is 14 plus hydrogen 1 total 14 plus 4, that is 18. 18, and what is the total charge? Total charge on it, it is 1. So its equivalent weight is 18. Yes, one more I'll solve for you, then you need to solve CO3 2 minus. If they ask you equivalent weight, okay, carbon is 12, oxygen is 16, 16, 3 is 48, 48 plus 250, that is 60. Divided by 2, why divided by 2? Check out here, the charge is 2. So its equivalent weight is 30. So it's very easy to find out equivalent weight of ions. Its formula weight upon total charge divided by total charge. Okay. Now, this one you solve. NO3 minus 1. SO4 minus 2. SO3 minus 2. PO4 minus 3, Cl minus, Ca plus 2, okay, first one let me check, because few of you are giving different answers. Students, nitrogen is 14. Oxygen is 16, 16, 3 is 48. Yes, students, this is 62 divided by 1. 62 divided by 1, that is 62. That's correct. First one is correct. Yes, for SO4 2 minus it is 48. That's correct. Yes, for SO3 minus 2, that is 40. That's correct. For PO4 minus 3, check out for PO4 minus 3. Phosphorus is 31 plus this 64. Yes, for phosphorus is, yes, Pranjal has given the correct answer, 31.6. For chlorine, it's very easy, 35.5. Yes, for calcium 2 plus, orally also you can tell. Yes, 20, very nice. Students, why you should know this? See here, why you should know this? If in question, why you should know this? In question, if it is asked, find the equivalent weight of metal carbonate. Find the equivalent weight of metal carbonate. But students, you don't know which metal it is. So can I split equivalent weight of metal plus equivalent weight of carbonate? Now, at least you can find equivalent weight of carbonate. Carbon is 12. Oxygen is 16. 16 is 48. So this comes out to be 60 and divided by 2. Now you understood why I have divided by 2. That is by charge. So it comes out to be 30. So can I write equivalent weight of metal carbonate is EM plus 30? Yes, students, can I write 30 here?
Yes.
Now, if equivalent weight of metal carbonate is given, equivalent weight of metal easily you can find because this 30 already you know. Okay, students, then what you do, one chart only you make that will, whichever questions are again and again repeating. Okay, first one was equivalent weight of metal carbonate that you can write as equivalent weight of metal plus 30. If I write equivalent weight of metal oxide, I'll write equivalent weight of metal plus 8 because I know 8 is the equivalent weight of oxygen. If equivalent weight of metal chloride, if I'll write, so I'll write EM plus 35.5. Then equivalent weight of metal nitrate, that is equivalent weight of metal plus 62. Now only you have found it. Then equivalent weight of metal sulfate is equal to equivalent weight of metal plus 48. And last one is equivalent weight of metal hydride, that is equivalent weight of metal plus 1. Students, you might have understood this. You have found CO3 minus 2. Oxygens, you know, Cl is minus 1. NO3 is minus 1. SO4 is minus 2. H is plus 1. This you know. The chart you write down. Yes, students, last two important questions we'll take. Have you written this? Either take the screenshot of it.
Sir, that EM plus 48, it is SO4, sir.
Okay. So, last two questions we'll see. See here. The question is equivalent weight of metal carbonate. Equivalent weight of metal carbonate is 50. Then equivalent weight of metal oxide will be, yes, solve this. Equivalent weight of metal carbonate is 50, then you need to find equivalent weight of metal oxide. Yes, 45, pronounce says 45. Yes, Pranav, can you tell me like this here? Equivalent weight of metal carbonate is equal to equivalent weight of metal plus 30. Can I write? Just now we have seen carbonate's equivalent weight is 30. So metal carbonate's equivalent weight, they have given 50. So can you find equivalent weight of metal here? So it comes out to be 50 minus 30. Correct? No, 30 will go and subtract there. So equivalent weight of metal comes out to be 20. But this is not an answer. This is not an answer. They asked you equivalent weight of metal oxide. So equivalent weight of metal oxide is equivalent weight of metal plus equivalent weight of oxygen. Just now we know equivalent weight of metal is 20 and equivalent weight of oxygen we all know is 8. So the answer comes 20. See, students, how interesting question was there. They asked about carbonate and suddenly they changed to metal oxide. So from carbonate, we can get the equivalent weight of metal, and that equivalent weight of metal, we can substitute with equivalent weight of oxygen, and that comes out to be equivalent weight of metal oxide. Yes, you understood how I solved this?
Yes, sir.
Students, please note down this, like this data. You will not get in any books. Okay, a question is for you. A metal oxide contains 40% oxygen by weight. A metal oxide contains 40% oxygen by weight. Its equivalent weight will be. Students, here it is written metal oxide contains 40%. Now only if this is the starting question. Yes, this is the starting question here. Metal oxide, if this is 60%, this has to be 40%. That time we used one formula. Percentage of oxygen upon percentage of metal is 8 upon equivalent weight of metal. So here if you substitute, sorry, this is 40. This is 40. This has to be 60. Yes, Pranav. Starting only we have solved this. 40 upon 60, 8 upon EM. So here equivalent weight of metal comes out to be 12. But students, they did not ask equivalent weight of metal. They asked equivalent weight of that metal oxide. Read the question carefully. A metal oxide, its equivalent weight will be. Metal oxide's equivalent weight, they asked. So I'll write equivalent weight of metal oxide is equal to equivalent weight of metal plus equivalent weight of oxygen. Equivalent of weight of metal, we already found it's 12. Equivalent weight of oxygen. Do you know what is the equivalent weight of oxygen? Equivalent weight
8
itself tells us it combines with 1 gram hydrogen, 8 gram oxygen or 35.5 grams chlorine. So what is the equivalent weight of oxygen, students?
Eight.
Yes, it's 8. So total 12 plus 8 comes out to be 20. So equivalent weight of metal oxide is 20. Yes, Pranav. Yes, understood, students.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes, everyone understood how to solve these types of questions. This were the questions asked in exam. Previously, these questions were asked. So it is very easy if you write down all the data first and then practice it. Yes, very nice, very nice. Okay, students. So that is all for today. Now, a last point of the chapter is left, that is called as volumetric analysis. From tomorrow onwards, we'll see this volumetric analysis. At least 2-3 lectures will be required for volumetric analysis. And this volumetric analysis is asked for IIT level. Yes, IIT level, this volumetric analysis is asked. That is titration, back titration, idiometric titration, idiometric titration. So a lot of calculations are there. At least it will take 2-3 lectures. And then the chapter is done. But you please keep on solving the questions which are provided to you. And if any doubt is there, yes, if any doubt is there, you please ask me. One or two doubt sessions also will take. All the questions will solve in this. But this question, students, these questions are interrelated. Once the complete chapter is done, then only most of the questions you can solve. But keep on solving the questions. Thank you, students.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
The problem, Shreyas, teaching on board is, this is our third lecture. We start at 1:30. Most of the your data is exhausted. So most of the students cannot see what is written on the board in the afternoon session. What is our problem that our lecture starts at 1:30. Till that time, two lectures you have seen already. Lot of internet is used in that. So at last the data is exhausted. So you are not able to clearly see what I have written. Yes, I will definitely try on board, but the same problem arises that you are not able to see what I have written on the board.
Yes, sir.
Okay, if you all, yes, now very few students are there. If you reach, if your data pack is more, then even we can start teaching on the board, but you should be, your data should be more and you should be clearly seeing what I have written on the board. Then only it will be effective. Okay, so thank you, students. Definitely we'll try to teach on board.
Sir, please upload the lecture.
Do you understand today's lecture? This was very important lecture, students. Very important lecture. Yes, did you understand the lecture?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, definitely I'll upload the lecture. Yes.